In this video, we will be discussing about a very important topic, that is about patterns. How to analyze and how to write a program to make sure that we can draw this pattern. Okay, so first of all, what you need to do is that you need to make grids along it, so that we can understand that how many rows and columns are there, and in which rows and in which cells this particular symbols are being displayed. Okay, this video is very important. Please give a bit more attention. So first of all, we have drawn the grid. Now what we will do is that we will just write down the number of rows and columns. So this first row, second row, third row and fourth row. This is first row, second row, third and fourth row. So now, so the this one below, this is the this falls under the outer loop. This falls under the outer loop. Since this outer loop is representing the rows, so we will represent as R, and this the columns are in the inner loop, so it will represent it with C, as in which indicates that it is a column. Now we will verify that how to draw this. So what you need to do is that you need to write something like this. So first of all, let's analyze. In the first cell, we are seeing that okay, just we write row and column. Okay, in the star symbol, as in first star is being printed at row one and column one. The second one, in the second row, we are seeing that okay, the stars are being printed at column one and column two. When the row is two, the stars are being printed at column 1 and column 2. In the row 3, we are seeing that the stars are being printed in the rows 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and 3. In the fourth row, we are seeing that the stars are being printed in the columns like 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and 3. Now we need to analyze each and every line. So how the rows and columns are being related. So you can see that okay, when the row is 1, the column is 1 as well. Row is 1 and column is 1. So we can write R equal to C. In the second line, what we are seeing that the first value, when the row is 2, the column is 1. So we can write that okay, the value of row is greater than 1. The value of row is greater than C. So we can write R greater than C. In here we are saying that okay, the row and column are same, so R equal to C. Again we will do this again, repeat this step. Row is greater than C because 3 is greater than 1. Row is greater than C 2, 3 is greater than 2 because R is greater than 3. And then row and column is same. Again row is greater than column, row is greater than column, and row is equal to column. So we can strictly see that okay, when the value of column is increasing the value of row, the stars are not being printed. So from here we can definitely find out okay, the relation between the R and C is that when this relation is occurring, this is a condition that okay, if when this condition is being put it out, then only we are seeing that this pattern is being printed. So we can say that R is greater than equal to C because R is greater than and when the value of row and column is also same, then there also the star is being printed. But where the value of column is greater than the row, there the star is not being printed. So we can verify that okay, R is greater than C. Now we will write the code. So the code will be for int I equal to okay. So R equal to, now what is the starting value? 1. R equal to 1. And where is being ended? At 4. So R is less than equal to 4. Then R plus plus. Then what we will write? For int. So this is the outer loop which I have already said before. Int c equal to 1, c is greater than equal to 4, c plus plus. Now look closely. In each of the rows, there is only a single pattern is being printed. So and the patterns are in the position of side by side. So we will use the statement system.out.print, not println, because if you write the println, the star will print it in this fashion, which will not make up our code. So system.out.print, inside that we'll just print out the star. So when this inner loop will be completed out, sorry, we have to write the condition first. So we have to write, if row is greater than equal to column, print system dot out dot print star, close the bracket if statement, and then we'll write in for the outer loop system dot out dot println. So what is happening over here? So when this pattern is being completed, this internal loop is completed out, it is going to the next line. So this next line is happening through system.out.println. So what is happening? Let us analyze. When value of r equal to 1, it goes inside here. Then c becomes 1. Now the first condition is being triggered. So r is greater than equal to c, since 1 is equal to 1. So it is true, star is being printed. Now when the value of c is being increased, when the value of c is 1, r is 1 and c is 2, the condition fails. This condition fails. So this inner loop gets exited out, and then the system.out.println is being printed. So this becomes your nested loop pattern 1. In the remaining video, we will discuss more and more programs and more patterns.